Shouts, screams, and bangs bombard me from every direction. Lively electronic sounds can be heard everywhere. The game arcade. And the two of us are standing in front of a cabinet enclosed with a vinyl curtain. Photo stickers?
Horoscope という占いなんです。What?
Horoscope.
簡単に言うと、 その、 天球地図のことなんです。
I don't get it.
すみません。 その、 天球地図というのは、 ある瞬間の、 天空の様子を図式化したもので、 それをもとに、 星々との位置関係を計算して、その人の運勢や未来とかを占うんです。ある瞬間というのは、様々な例が挙げられるんですけど、占いに使うのは、その人が生まれた時の天球地図を使うのが多いです。Well,
like I said, I don't get it.
その…
Make it concise and easy to understand.
星占いです。Just
say so in the first place. So, you want to try that?
その…
Her eyes look hesitant, as if she's trying to gauge my feelings. However, it seems her mind is already one with the fortune-telling cabinet. She's glancing in its direction. She's probably holding back because of me. Jeez. I sigh and walk forward. There's a short, pitiful sound. What are you doing? Are we doing it? The fortune-telling? A different sound than the one just now. Fujibayashi trots along behind me. I flip over the vinyl curtain and stand in front of the cabinet. As the curtain blocks the light outside, the inside of the cabinet is illuminated only by the monitor's bluish-white light. It feels like we're in this mystery space. Faint background music is playing. On the monitor, the planets of the solar system, Earth included, spin around them. This is a nice atmosphere.
Hi.
Is it accurate?
どうでしょう。私もこういうものでするのは初めてですから。
I see. Well, throw it again for two people having their fortune told together, huh?
Hi.
It's okay. I'll pay. I saw Fujibayashi who's trying to take her wallet out. Grab some coins from my pocket. Clank, clank, clank. Ba-plomp. That's a sound. Good old ba-plomp. Once I insert the money, the planets on the monitor gather in the center as if they were being sucked in by the sun. I then hit the start button. The screen fades to white and a name input screen is shown. What do? Type our names in?
この水晶玉で入力するんだと思います。This?
In the center of the cabinet is an artificial crystal ball. Looks like we type our names in by rolling it. The cursor, shaped like a feather, begins to move as the crystal ball rotates. Roll, 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 plop. Roll, 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 plop. Roll, 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 plop. Once we finish typing in our names, it moves on to a gender selection menu. The symbols male and female are now floating on the screen. Well, this isn't anything difficult. I move the cursor towards male and hit the enter button. Next, I need to punch in my date and time of birth. Wait, how am I supposed to know when exactly I was born? I don't even fucking know that, honestly. I was born sometime between midnight and midnight of a certain day. That's my approximation. I guess. In that case, I'll just throw something in there. Yeah, let's say I was born at 9 a.m. Womp. Next map of Japan is shown on the monitor. Jesus Christ, what's next? You ask for my goddamn fucking social security number? Christ. Gives your name, date, age of birth, your date of birth, your location you were born in, what's your mother's maiden name, what's the name of your first pet, what's the name of the school you went to, what was its mascot? What high school did your father attend? On the top left corner of the screen, the latitude launched to where the cursor is pointed at is shown.
それも大まかでいいと思います。
I was born in this country, right here. Yeah. Well, I was probably born in the area, so let's just say about here. I wonder what I was supposed to do if I was born outside the country. The plop. The monitor flashes white, and the name input menu is shown once again. There, it's your turn. Wait, bro, she places her hand in the crystal ball in a panic. Roll. With difficulty, she moves the cursor to enter her name. She passes by her name several times and finally arrives on the letters Ryo on the screen. Took her twice as long as it took me. Next are the male and female symbols. What's the matter?
You
got something to tell me, Ryo? She says, moves the crystal ball. Cursor shakily moves towards the male symbol. Are you like that? That symbol's for guys. Could it be that you don't know what these symbols mean? I mean, that's fair. They do? Besides, didn't you see me picking male just now? Okay, the one for guys is something like an arrow pointing out, right? That represents an arrowhead.
Yajiri.
Which means since it's something used for hunting, it represents men.
なるほど.
Wait, is that like the actual reason behind it? I never like looked into why the symbols are shaped the way they are. Does that make it easier to remember? I mean, it's easier to remember because the male symbol looks like you got the pointy bit and then the circular bit. It's a cock and balls, alright? It's cock and balls. So which one are you picking? Really bug me if you picked male. Why? Huh? Listen, Okazaki, we need to have a talk about acceptance, alright? In a flurry, Fujibashi quickly rolls the crystal, moving the cursor to the female symbol. Then the screen for inputting the date and time of birth appears. Again, she inputs her details, one character at a time, with shaky, uncertain movements. September 9th, huh? Ah, 99. Fujibayashi nods, she inputs her time of birth. Cursor wavers about unevenly, but it is moving with a clear purpose. You actually know when you were born?
お母さんに聞きましたから.
Why would you ask her that?
その占いには必要だと思ったので.
Of course you would. Do you do this kind of fortune telling yourself?
はい.
I see. That man's way off. I saw the words before I say them. Since she's doing this because she likes to, it'd be mean for me to say it. After a bit of time, Fujibashi finishes inputting her place of birth, too. Plomp. I love that sound effect. Once again, the monitor turns white and moves to the next screen. Text appears against a twinkling starry backdrop. It's the fortune-telling's menu. There are multiple options presented on the screen. And the very first option among them, love. Your relationship, huh? What do we select? Oh, what do we do? Actually, we'll save. I think I'm gonna bust the save here. I think I'm gonna bust the save. I'm gonna write a little memo. I'm gonna type in relationship. I want to remember that one. We're gonna come back to that. Because I feel like if we say, yeah, no, we're just friends. And then we cut, and then we go down Kyo's route. Bada boom. But if we say now, like, it doesn't matter either way. The guide would tell me if it was an important choice. It isn't. But I'd feel better going down Kyo's route if I, you know, heavily implied to Ryo here that we're just homies. Don't get it twisted. But honestly, I am kind of feeling Ryo more than Kyo. And I haven't gotten to the choice where I have to pick one or the other, but I'm kind of feeling like we, well, since we're doing this, might as well. If we're having our fortune told together, this would probably be more fun. Move the feather cursor toward the word lovers. A moaning sound can be heard next to me. Before the cursor overlaps the text, I take a glance at Fujibayashi. Whoa! Fujibayashi's face is blushing deep red. She looks like she's about to faint. We're friends, right? I quickly move the cursor over the word friends and press the confirm button. I guess she's not the type of person to get this kind of joke. With her face still colored in crimson, Fujibayashi is staring at the monitor. For a while, the atmosphere between us was tense. Good. The menu's text fades away, leaving only the stars and the night sky on the screen. Shortly thereafter, text again appears on the night sky on the screen. Please place your hands on the crystal ball, huh? It's referring to the crystal ball I used to move the cursor just now, right? I lay my hand on the crystal ball. What's wrong? If you don't put your hand on here, it's not going to continue. With my prompting, Fujibayashi timidly lays her hand on top of mine. I feel a gentle and soft sensation on the back of my hand. Hell yeah. Your hand's pretty warm. Hey, don't let it go now. We can't continue if you do. Once again, her hand gently lays on top of mine. Perhaps because she's aware that our hands are overlapping, her palm feels just a little stiffer. I'm pressing confirm. I check once again that Fujibayashi's hand is laid on top of mine by feeling for its warmth and press the confirm button. Planets emerge on the screen and around the sun. They evolve once again. The background music switches to a mysterious sounding track. As the curtain tucks us away from the outside world, the atmosphere actually feels rather legitimate. Fortune tellers in their shop probably give off this same atmosphere too. Fujibayashi looks at me, her eyes look as if she's struck with wonder. No, rather she is struck with wonder. As proof, the stiffness that I felt in her hand has completely disappeared. Suddenly, a change occurs in the world inside the monitor. The planets, which have been revolving around the sun, now start to separate to opposite ends of the screen. They then blink several times and start to fade away. At almost exactly the same time, the crystal ball which we laid our hands on starts to glow faintly. Before long, all the planets have completely disappeared, and the sun draws near us. The sun accelerates towards us, expanding to cover the monitor, and turns the screen white. Oh? The screen fades into a scene of shooting stars streaming across the night sky. Then the names which we entered earlier appear on the screen. Furthermore, words. Looks like the results are out. I look to my side and find Fujibayashi staring intently at the monitor. You could perhaps even say she's pouring herself into it. It might actually make me kind of jealous to know that she has something like that. It doesn't matter if it's a game or fortune-telling. It is something that doesn't necessarily appeal to everyone. I don't have anything like that.
Okazaki-kun?
Huh?
どうしたんですか?
What do you mean?
その難しい顔してました.
Oh, I'm sorry. Fujibayashi glances back at the monitor. As if lured by her, I also do the same. This week, the two of you will have some good conversations, and you'll finally understand each other's feelings. The two of you are like-minded, so if you can find common interests and go together to different places, you will surely have a meaningful, enjoyable time together. However, you must not get ahead of yourself. If you attempt to take control, it may only serve to distance the two of you. Rather than being too serious, spend your time together as friends. Your lucky items are stuffed toy and picnic sheets. Your lucky color is white. If it's true that the results are not bad. As I murmur, the text on the screen fades away, leaving behind only the starry night sky. In the bottom of the cabinet, around where my knee is, there's a sound of something, perhaps a receipt, being printed out. Something's coming out.
Oh,結果です.
I see. Nice. Finally, the results are completely printed out. I look at Fujibayashi, whose hand reaches out for it. I don't really want it. I don't really mind, but what are you doing with it? Don't worry about it, dude. I know there are people who collect printed stickers and file them, but I think there's a girl who collects the results from fortune-telling games. Yes, but that's okay. Doesn't really matter, does it? These sorts of things differ from people to people. It's kind of like a memento, no? She nods, suddenly her eyes widen as if she just realized something. What's wrong?
新しいバインダーを買わないと
For filing?
はい 新しいジャンルですので
What? Astrological fortunes? Leaving that aside, does that mean she has just as many binders as there are types of fortune telling?
いえ ホロスコープ用のバインダーはあるんですけど
But She suddenly blushes and looks down at the ground. If it's hard for you to say, you don't have to force yourself, you know. Good, then I won't. Fujibayashi takes out a clear file from her bag, puts a sheet of fortune-telling results in it neatly such that it would not crimp, and puts it back inside her bag. Let's go then. It was a small detour, but we're back on the road for home once again. The shadows on the ground now stretch even longer than earlier. Hey, tell me my luck tomorrow. Fujibayashi pulls her deck of cards from her pocket. She then clumsily holds them out to me as she's walking.
どうぞ.
Guess I'll take this one. I pull out a card. It's the Two of Spades.
これまでと変わらない。
I see. I've already given up hope on Fujibayashi's fortunes. This probably means I'll probably be involved in some sort of trouble tomorrow. Thanks, I'll be careful. Ah, never mind. Pretend you didn't hear that. Okay. I stop my yawn, keep strolling down the usual path to school. The sun is hanging somewhat high, shining down on the road that's void of people. The hour hand of the clock is already pointed at 9. I am lazily walking towards school with my bag held tight under my armpit and my hands inside my pockets. Well, it's just the same as usual. I murmur, even though there's nobody else here. Classes end at noon today. The first period's probably over already, so I guess I'm starting with second period. Given how sleepy I am, I should be able to catch a few good naps in the three remaining periods. And after lunch, yeah, I guess I'll go spend time in Tsunohara's room. Vroom vroom. A menacing aura approaches from behind me. Instinctively, I leap to my right. A familiar girl speeds past me right through the area I once occupied. She then brakes suddenly. The rear wheel screeches and finally comes to a stop a little farther down.
Chih!
What the hell's with that tisk? She says and smiles nonchalantly. So, guess you're late again, huh?
あんたとここで会うってことはそういうことね.
What an amazing class president.
いやー、それほどでも.
I'm not praising you.
それより、昨日はかっこよかったわね.
What do you mean? Kyou grins, likely hiding something behind her smile, and clears her throat. She then adapts a serious expression and begins to speak in a slightly different voice.
もうちょっと前向きにものを考えてみたらどうだ? 消極的なのは性格だから仕方ないかもしれないけど、考え方こうして一緒に帰っているんだ。 本当に嫌ならこうして横にはいないし。 それなり…
As she finishes, a grin breaks out in her face. Did you follow us again?
え? まさか!
Yeah, that's why you were able to quote it perfectly word for word, right? Liar. She's not the kind of girl who would tell you things like that.
じゃあ、あれよ。噂。他の子が見てて教えてくれたの。多分学校行ったら、もうその話題で持ちきりね。公認カップルよ。
She gives me a thumbs up and winks. In response, I let out a sigh. Oh, we did kiss after all. I'm surprised you knew. I wonder why she's so bad at lying. You haven't even gotten to school yet. Where'd you hear those rumors? I should be the one who's pissed here.
あんたがネチネチとつまんない追求するから悪いんでしょ?
What a terrible girl.
朝から気分が悪いわね. もう先に行くから.
Hey, Kyou.
何を?
Let me ride on the back. Ah! Suddenly the bike speeds right toward me. The front cowl mercilessly attacks my legs.
It wouldn't
hurt once in a while.
I don't have that kind
of money.
Kyou
says, and as always, accelerates and drifts her rear wheel, turning the bike around. As white smoke comes out of its muffler, the bike zooms away. Kyou's hair flutters in the wind. Damn. I stroke my aching leg and slowly totter my way to school. The hallway is dead quiet. Well, of course, first period hasn't ended yet. What are you still doing here? You got here not that long before a guy who came here by foot, eh? Your bike's crying, you know? Kyou pouts as she walks this way. What's that you have there?
Tegami.
Thinking about her look, I can see about 7 to 8 cute looking envelopes. Who are they for?
Atashi.
She says, sounding somewhat bothered by the fact. She really starts looking at the letters one by one. The stickers used to seal them are shaped like hearts. Are these love letters?
So you mono kana.
You're actually pretty popular, aren't you? Kyou sighs exhaustedly. She hands me a few of the letters. What? Even if you give them to me.
Sashidashi ni.
Who sent them? I do as I'm told and look at the letters. Names are written in round, cute letters. Michiko Yukishima, Saki Toro. Women. Kyou?
Hoka no mo miru?
No, I'll pass. Her shoulders stoop, Kyou lets out an even deeper sigh than earlier.
Why not? What's
wrong with that? What's wrong with getting some from the ladies?
この学校の男たちの目って濁りすぎて黒いのかしら?
Well, isn't it fine just knowing that there's someone who likes you?
あのね、女の子に告られても正直困るの。傷つけずに断るのって結構大変なんだからね。
You hypocrite.
なんか言った?
You're hearing things. I ignore Kyo's sharp glare. So what are you doing with the letters? Are you throwing them out?
バカ!そんなひどいことしないわよ!ちゃんと読んで返事するに決まってるでしょ?
You're strangely diligent, you know?
変は余計よ。中には相談事に乗ってほしいって内容のもあるんだから。
Well, gee, I guess that makes you kind. Well, she does take care of others to the point where it becomes a bother. It's almost like she's an older sister that you can rely on. I guess that does make her more popular with girls and guys.
Oh, そうそう。
She slowly hands me one of the envelopes. It's sealed with a sticker of a cat. What's this?
手紙.
I can tell. Doesn't handing someone a chain letter kind of count as harassment?
ちゃんと物見てから言いなさいよ.
As instructed, I take a good look at the letter. There's a glittering cat sticker used to seal the flap. It's not that thick either. Just means that there isn't much inside.
表よ、表.
The front? Turn my wrist to look at the other side of the letter. On it is... There's nothing written on it, you know?
Eh? Uso! Chotto kashite!
Here. Kyou takes the letter and stares at it.
Acha! Ano ko namae kaki wasureteru janai! Shouganai ka.
Kyou puts her hand inside her bag and takes something out. Then she turns away from me. What are you doing?
Yoshitto!
Kyou hands me the letter once again. I don't really understand what's going on, but I look at the front of the letter that I was handed. Where it was once blank, there's now words hastily scribbled with a black marker. Fujibayashi. Hello?
So, Ryou kara anta e. Love letter. Doushita no? Odoroiteru?
No, it's just that your handwriting is terrible, you know?
Urusai wa ne! Sonna no dou demo ii desho?
It was just bugging me. In any case, why a letter? Hell, since she's in the same class, couldn't she have handed it to me directly?
Bakka ne. Otome no hajirai tte shitteru?
I say you take out the letter and compare handwriting. Well, that certainly doesn't apply to you.
Huh?
Just talking to myself, never mind. Kyou says she threatens me by sticking her finger against my chest. You got it. In any case, I nod. Yo, just got her too, huh?
Aikawarasune. Te, nani boto shiteru no?
Kimi ra te, yappari sou nano?
Huh?
Nani ga?
With a weird look on his face, he points his finger at the area between me and Kyou. What he's pointing at is the letter. Hey, you've got it wrong.
Kore wa
Listen, no, it's just a love letter. Calm down. Hey.
What?
Hey, don't just walk away without saying anything.
Okazaki, mizukusaiyo. Tomodachi da to omotteita no ni sa. Konna daijina koto tamatteru nante.
Tsunahara, you.
Inda. Tomodachi da kara koso iinikui koto tte no mo aru yo ne. Boku wa kini shinai yo. Konna koto de koarete shimau yo na.
No, I mean, you actually think we're friends? No, our friendship is so tight, like this will come between us. You think we're friends? Or an underling, or an errand boy. Tsunahara runs away in tears. For some strange reason, Kyou and I watch him run away with smiles on our faces. Hey, we didn't tell him what was going on. You were picking on him too.
Nah, mo, owa yo. Chanto gokai o tokanakya.
Yeah. We not at the same time run after Tsunahara, who's running far away into the distance. During class, the English teacher keeps yapping incomprehensible things that sound like magical spells. I cannot understand a single word that reaches my ears. Though since I was never trying to listen to begin with, of course I wouldn't understand a thing. I glance in a different direction, towards Fujibayashi. She's staring at the chalkboard with a serious look. I look back at my own desk. I'm holding the letter that Kyou handed me this morning. I still haven't even opened it. Well, it is supposed to be from Fujibayashi, but it feels really suspicious. In any case, guess I'll read it. I quietly peel off the cat sticker, then I take the letter out of the envelope. Its contents are really simple and easy to understand. It's just a single sentence written in round letters. What a dodgy letter. It's so short I have no idea whether it was really Fujibayashi who wrote this. In any case, his handwriting is different than the one in the front of the envelope. If the letter was just a little longer, then I'm sure Kyou would have messed up somewhere if she wrote this. I sigh, and once again look at Fujibayashi. She likes me, huh? It all feels somewhat surreal. It's true, you can really tell from the way Fujibayashi's been acting that her reaction hasn't been normal. But still, it'd be really egotistical of me to simply write that off as her having a crush on me. Nevertheless, I am certain Kyou has her hand in this as well. I look up at the sky and sigh. I guess I'll have to be at least somewhat prepared for it. Ding dong. The bell rings, ending homeroom. Club members, go home club, or otherwise, all head outside the classroom in droves. I also take my bag and stand up from my seat. Then I look at Fujibayashi's seat. She's not there anymore. I wasn't mistaken, she was the first one to dash out of the classroom after the bell had chimed. She was likely headed for the courtyard. I looked at the letter I had put in my shirt pocket. Well, what's with you popping up behind me all of a sudden?
その手紙、朝藤林から受け取ったやつだよね。
So?
なんて書いてあったの?
It has nothing to do with you.
やっぱり二人は僕の知らないとこで熱々だったんだ。
That's not happening, so you don't need to worry.
いや、僕は信じないね。男の固い友情が壊れる一番の原因、それは女だ。旧約聖書を見ろ。アダムを堕落させたのはイブだ。女だ。
He clenches his impassioned fist and says with such vigor that it feels like there's a menacing aura whirling around us. The girls who are still in the classroom give Tsunahara a good stare.
僕は岡崎、お前を守ってみせるぞ。そして、永遠の友情を築くんだ。
You're being annoying, so go home.
ひど、あんた血も涙もないっす。 大体藤林今日のどこがいいんだよ。あんな凶暴暴悪悪辣な人でなし、絶対遊ばれてるだけだって。後で泣き見るぜ。悪いことは言わないからさ、僕と一緒に帰ろう。新しいエッチな本手に入れたんだ。
Did he have a bad experience with girls in the past?
あ、やっぱまだいた。
来やがったな悪の権化。岡崎はお前に渡さないぞ。
どうせあんたのことだから教室で生き悩んでるんじゃないかって思ったのよね。
僕と岡崎の友情は固いんだ。女なんかにつけ入る隙はないぞ。
もうサイは投げられたのよ。
どれだけ固いかって言うとね、1ヶ月机の中に入れっぱなしにしてた給食のパン並みさ。
ま、結果を出すのはあんただけどさ。
はっきり言ってすごいよ。水深100万メートルでも耐えられるぜ。
私の期待は裏切らないわよね。
友情最高。
なあもううるさい。
バッ。
I have no idea where she got it from, but there's now a Japanese-English dictionary lodged in the area between Tsunade's eyebrows. He then falls flat on his back and stops moving. Hey, you hit him with the corner just now, didn't you?
大丈夫よ。まだ息してるっぽいし。
He's also twitching.
それより、ちゃんと寮の気持ちを受けんのよ。
Accept it. What about how I feel?
この際無視。
Don't give me that bullshit.
あんな可愛い子が彼女になるのよ。どこに不満があるの？
Well, nothing really.
つべこべ言わず、付き合いなさいって。ダメなら別れちゃえばいいだけでしょ？
Break up. It's easy for you to say.
まあ、別れるときは、漏れなく現世ともお別れだけどね。付き合わなきゃわからないことがたくさんあるし、付き合って初めてわかることもたくさんあるわよ。友達として仲を深めていくより、恋人として仲を深めていった方がいいでしょ？その方が時間を有意義に使ってると思うしさ。
She's twisting the logic so well that I have no way to rebut. Fine, I'll go.
うん。
I take my bag and walk toward the door.
あ、トモヤ。
うん。
あ、
What is it?
うん、なんでもない。頑張ってね。
You should have told your sister that instead.I say as I wave my hand and walk out of the classroom. The sunlight shines through the gaps in the leaves onto the stone fence. The place is filled with the scent of lush greenery. It is also surprisingly secluded from the main campus. I often use this place when I ditch class, but I had never thought such a big event would occur here. I step on the grass and hear it being crushed underfoot. I slowly walk forward one step at a time. My destination is... In the distance, I see Fujibayashi.She appears to be waiting for someone as she sits on the stone fence. She's holding her bag with both her hands, her eyes fixed to the ground. She was like this yesterday at the school gate as well. Girlfriend, huh? I take a deep breath and relax my shoulders in preparation for what's to come. Yo, sorry to keep you waiting.
Okazaki-kun. I... その別に... 全然待ってないです。
I read your letter. Right after I say that, she blushes. Her eyes, though still looking toward the ground, start to shift about restlessly.
Hi. Sumimasen.
Rephrase your sentence better, please.
その、呼び出してしまっ、すごく失礼かと思ったんですけど、でも、頑張ったんですけど、あれが精一杯で、その、
She suddenly apologizes. There was something you wanted to tell me, right?
Hi.
She looks at me, her shoulders shuddering. However, it was only for an instant. She immediately looks back down at the ground. Regardless, I wait for Fujibayashi to start. She tightens her grip on her bag she's holding. Then, as if finally making up her mind, she takes a deep breath.When she looks at me, I can now see her eyes are gleaming with strong determination. Her face is red, but her spirit is simply unbelievable for the usually timid Fujibayashi.
私、岡崎君のこと、好きです。
Yeah, thanks. The silence is deafening. Is she going to follow through and ask me to go out with her? It'd be strange if I asked her instead. But, She says with a frantic looking expression and glances towards me. She takes a deep breath in preparation of the words about to follow. She says and bows her head. You know, Fujibayashi. Her head bounces back up to answer me. Her face is still deep red. Thanks. But to tell you the truth, I don't really know you that well. Well, it wasn't until this year that we ended up in the same class, so we never had the opportunity to. In response to my onslaught of words, Fujibayashi's head droops. Feels as though I've been saying something mean to her. I don't really know how it'll turn out if we go out under these circumstances. But, you know, I suppose we could give it a try. But if it's okay with you, let's give it a try. She looks at me in astonishment. We still don't know each other that well. But I think if we don't spend more time together, we won't get to know each other. Instead of getting to know each other as friends, I think maybe it's not a bad idea if we get to know each other as boyfriend and girlfriend. She blinks her eyes and looks at me slightly dumbfounded. What I said, what she heard. Seems like she's organizing all these ideas in her head right now. Then, as if the results have finally been computed, she tightens her grip of her bag. As of this moment, you're my girlfriend. That sounds okay? Fujibayashi? Before Fujibayashi could look at me, teardrops emerged from her eyes and dripped down her face. Fujibayashi? Did I say something weird? Fujibayashi. She must really have feelings for me. Until now, I had never really thought that someone would need me so much. I don't intend to go back on my word. Teardrops continue to rush down Fujibayashi's face. I gently reach out my hand and grab the soggy cheek. It's pretty soft. Huh? Then I gently pinch it. That means it's not a dream. Fujibayashi's eyes widen in shock. I let go of her cheek and instead put my hand on her forehead. You're my girlfriend already. So stop crying. She wipes her face with her uniform sleeves. Then she turns toward me with a bright smile.
Tomoya!
With a thumb, Fujibayashi pushes me in the chest. Its impact, well, there isn't much of one, causing me to take a few steps back. The very same moment, something breezes by my ear. So quickly that I can feel my ears ringing. What I heard next was a swoosh, followed by the sound of something crashing to the ground. I look at my feet apprehensively, and there I find a Kojin dictionary caved deeply into the ground. I don't need to know what it means. It's a dictionary. It's big, thick book. That idiot. If she actually hit me, I would have died.
Tomoya! Anta nani ryou o nakasete no?
You were spying on us again, weren't you?
Hitogiki no arui koto iwanai de yo! Shinpai datta kara, kossori kanshi shite tadake yo!
That's what you call spying.
Ano...
Besides, what's the big idea with this thick book? Pretty serious problem if it actually hit my head.
Neratta no wa kubi yo!
That's even worse.
Ano... Onee-chan... 岡崎くん、二人とも喧嘩は良くないと思い。
りょう。
はい。
あんた、このバカに何言われたの？ほっぺまでつねられてたけど大丈夫？
あれは。
ともや、あんた女の子の顔になんてことしてくれちゃってんのかしらね。
Ugh, sheesh, none of your business. Shut up, will ya?
Gaia? 誰がガイアよ。りょうは私の妹よ。
Well, I'm her boyfriend. Can't you be more polite?
誰を丁重に。
彼氏? Her eyes blink repeatedly. Her expression looks like a pigeon that was hit with a pea shooter.
誰が?
I point at myself silently.
誰の?
I point at Fujibayashi with the same finger.
てことは…
Kyou looks back and forth between me and Fujibayashi.
あの、岡崎くん、ふつつかんものですけど、その…
That's how it is.
え?そうなんだ。そういうことだったんだ。そっかそっか。二人は付き合うんだ。
Kyou scratches her head and smiles exaggeratedly. She immediately turns toward Fujibayashi and grabs her hand.
よかったね。
これもお姉ちゃんのおかげ。
Fujibayashi says happily while smiling, just a few teardrops left.
新しく買ったバインダーも無駄になんなかったし。
それは…
New binder? You mean the one for horoscopes?
ホロスコープってジャンルのバインダーじゃないわよね。
お姉ちゃん。
名付けるなら、恋人用のバインダ
ー? I see.
たくさん詰まるといいわね。ラブラブバインダー。
ラブラブバインダー。Embarrassed, Fujibayashi wails. Still feels somewhat surreal that I have a girlfriend now. Alright, see what the 28th brings us. So the 28th here is where our divide is. This is where we actually pick. Do we stick with Ryou? Or do we now decide to turn around and go after Kyou? And like, after what's happened so far, I don't want to say no to Ryou. The guide says I should go just for Kyou, and that Ryou is optional. But like, I don't know. Maybe I'm just too considerate for fictional characters' feelings, but goddamn it. After all this, just to be like, nah, I want your sister though. Like, it's past noon. I yawn as I walk down the empty path to school. Feels like I kick something soft. Continues to roll across the ground and finally stops when it hits a streetlight. Short legs suddenly sprout from what I thought was a round clump. I walk closer toward it, it's fucking both on. Then fearfully, I look at the clump. It's Kyou's baby boar. Crap, I totally kicked him. It actually felt pretty good, too. Hey, Botan, you okay? Open your eyes, don't be a fool. You shouldn't sleep here. Come on, wake up. I actually hit you that hard now, did I? No, seriously, please, wake up. If something happens to you, Kyou will kill me. Botan. Botan? Botan. What should I do? Should I just pretend nothing happened and take off? If there are no witnesses, then no one would know I was the one who knocked him out. Act like it's a tragedy. That's just not my problem. It's not like I'm trying to go after a kill or anything, so why would I want to do anything nice, you know? That's right, I'll just walk away. Feel sorry for both of them, but this is by far the best choice. I'll let some other kind soul take care of you instead. I just hope that stray dogs don't come along and start chewing on you. I look around to make sure there are no witnesses around. Did you see that? Okay, kid, I'll give you 10 yen so you keep your mouth shut, okay?
Makasete. Kou miete mo boku, kuchi ga katakute yumei nanda.
I can tell by how much you're talking right now. I see. Let's throw in another 10 and make it 20 then.
Arigato!
Yaa! Gomen, mata!
Heiki datta yo. Kono o niichan ga urin koketteru no mite tara,
Watching this guy kick a pig. And you call yourself tight-lipped, huh? Hey, wait up. Damn, got away quickly. What a waste of 20 yen. Click my tongue as I look down at the motionless Bothan. Guess it'd be a bad idea to leave him here. Okay. Pick up Bothan, who's dead as a doorknob, by his back. Bothan? Are you alive? So are you hungry? I see. If he's alive and well, then it'd be a good idea to take him to Kyou. Place Bothan on my right shoulder. I'll take you to your owner. Yeah, jeez, stop licking me. You smell terrible.